The next speaker is somebody that I first connected with through the Global City Teams Challenge program. And since then, we keep bumping into each other in overlapping circles. So I'm especially excited to welcome to the stage Jean Rice. Please give her a round of applause and welcome.
So great to be with you today and feel the energy and everyone looking at how to make a region better for workforce development, economic development, innovation, and lots of great transportation applications. I'm just glad I'm up here and I don't have to worry about the whole tie thing, so I'm glad to be here. I work with the National Telecommunications and Information Administration. We're a part of the Department of Commerce. And like Scott, our agency is trying to find ways to help cities and regions work at and innovate this whole smart city ecosystem. And the question is, how do we do it? So let me tell you a little bit about what our agency does. We work on many things. One, we manage federal spectrum. And you know, if you think about what's gonna happen, and they say by 2025, there's gonna be 30 to 50 billion more sensors out there, we need to share spectrum. And that's something that our agency is working on very diligently. We also have a multi-stakeholder group working on cybersecurity and privacy. And we have a group that I work for, which is called Broadband USA, which works with cities and communities, companies and others to try to improve connectivity throughout rural areas and places where they don't have it. Work with them also where they need more infrastructure in cities and ex-urban areas as well. And we also look at how can we help develop the whole smart city infrastructure in a way that is, I would say, people-centric. You know, I look at it in terms of, you know, everyone here, and I especially appreciated the council people talking about what their issues were, and I talk about people here talking about looking at transportation, mobility, whether it's on the ground or in the air, and how to connect, and also looking at how you can improve people's lives. And so the whole people-centric design and solution is something we look at. And we also get a chance to look around the nation at what's being done. So for example, in Boston, they had an issue like, how do I find out when my child's bus is nearby? So they had open data on transportation, they did a hackathon, and now they have an app so that people can find out where it is. You know, in a rural community in San Mateo County, they had a problem, a homework gap. Low-income folks could not get access to broadband. They put in public Wi-Fi, and people did come and do the homework. Not only did the people who live there do their homework, but, you know, migrant farmers from all over came in and used it for homework. It had kind of some unusual aspects, too. Because everyone was coming in, there was big economic development in that area. And it also affected public safety. One time, all the other networks are down, and it was the only network with us up. Now it's looking at it as a backbone for public safety. So, you know, your ideas here are going to be great, and I think, you know, you can learn from other cities just like we do in other regions, and I think it would be great. One of the things we try to work on is cross-silo and cross-border and cross-sector collaboration. And we do that by working with industry, with universities, with communities and cities, nonprofits, and any organization that is looking to kind of move forward this whole dialogue and do boots on the ground. How do we work it out? It's, you know, we're all gonna have to pivot a little bit, we're gonna have to learn as we go, but the goal is, how do we get there? One of the things we're doing on the federal level is we participate in the NYDERG Smart Cities and Communities Task Force, and we do that with DOT and ITA and, you know, lots of other agencies that are also looking at how do we support local governments. And as a group, we've pretty much said that our role is, you know, whether you're funding from NSF or you're looking at DOE for microgrids and smart grid kind of technologies, what is it that we can work together on to make sure that we can help communities with where they want to go with it? And that's going, I think, very, very well. We also work with the same group that Scott does, which is the Global Cities Team Challenge, which is with our sister agency who runs it, NIST. It's run by Soku Ri. And it's a great program, which is basically trying to get cities, industry, universities, and others to work together so that they can collaborate, learn, and as they do it, scale a project, make sure it's sustainable, work on interoperability, and try to make it work in the local level. Then, you know, we do that through what we call action clusters, putting groups together. then about a year ago, we said, hey, we're learning so much from the ground up on these action clusters, we should start a super clusters. So we have them in many areas, including transportation, public safety, public Wi-Fi and wireless, and the whole light and utilities, and they develop blueprints so that every community does not have to start from scratch. You can get an idea, some ideas that have come. So I do suggest you go on the Global City Teams Challenge website, take a look at the blueprints. They're really helpful depending on what sector you're interested in. Take a look at them. And then I'm hoping that some of you will also collaborate with us on that. And I just want to mention that part of what we do is we, with NTIA, NIST, and NSF, foster a forum for the leaders of the superclusters, which come from all sectors, to work together on how do we collaborate and how do the federal agencies help you. Now, I just want to mention we have several people who are leaders from the GCTC. Would you mind standing up? Zach? It's just an amazing amount of work and effort, and I know that Zach had you all congratulate yourselves, but you need to congratulate yourselves as well. Let me give you a hand again for you guys. I just think that we have a lot of superclusters. The ones that NTIA is particularly fostering is the wireless supercluster. So we're looking at different technologies and how they will help and support governments and. That's going to be kind of the next level. Last year it was a public Wi-Fi blueprint. This time it's going to be looking at new technologies, and every year will be separate technologies. There's a new supercluster starting on education. We have one that is started on smart ag and rural, where we're also looking at not just farming, smart ag, but we're also looking at different things like rural communications and connectivity and how to help rural communities with healthcare. And there's just amazing kind of things happening there, like supply chain analysis and smart sensing for food sheds. Just a tremendous amount of activity and peace. So I just have to say that this is an exciting day again, and I really would want to learn from you and what you're doing. It sounds like you've got a great beginning, and anything we can do to help, please let us know. Thank you.